Okay, crafty friends, so I am demoing the Arteza self-healing mat and the Arteza rotary cutter today. I've hauled this in an Arteza haul in the past, and I'm just getting a chance to show it on my channel, but I wanted to show you how easy it is to use. I did make a DIY backdrop using a plastic tablecloth that I picked up from Hobby Lobby. It's in their party section and it is 99 cents. And I am going to put this video together so that you can see what the backdrop looked like. And I just wanted to show you how I actually use the self-healing mat and this rotary cutter to create my background. So what I did was basically when you take the tablecloth out of the package, you wanna unfold it. Now I just kept mine like this and I'm leaving a little room up here because I don't want to cut that part. I'm leaving this part open so that I have room to fold it over my little backdrop. So I just folded it like so and I'm placing it on my mat, my cutting mat. And you just wanna make sure it's smooth and it's centered. And it doesn't even have to be perfect. But I am just using the lines that are on the cutting mat. It does go up to 24 inches, and I'm just lining it up with the line. And then I'm just using my ruler, and I'm placing it down, and I am going to use that as a guide when I cut my tablecloth. So I have my guide right here and I'm just gonna kind of push this back so you guys can see what I'm doing. I'll zoom in just a little bit, but it's so simple to do. So basically I just take my ruler and I have my blade and all you do is push down and now the blade is ready to use. They do sell a replacement set. You get a pack of like six, I believe, or seven. It's easy to replace. All you have to do is unscrew this and carefully place your blade back on and screw it back together. Super simple to use and it cuts beautiful. So I'm gonna show you how I cut this table mat. So I just placed my ruler on the tablecloth and I just started on the edge and I'm just giving it a firm push and I'm going all the way up. And again, it's not perfect. It doesn't have to be perfect. And you'll see when I'm done. But basically, I'm just kind of using this ruler as a guide to do the cutting. And I'm just gonna push down. And I'll go through until I finish. But I just wanted to show you how easy this is to use. It glides no problem. And as you can see, my strips are forming for my background. I've been having a lot of fun doing DIY background photo drops, or DIY photo backgrounds, I guess that's what you call it. And I've been, you know, I did one for my daughter's graduation and I did one for my twins' pool party. And that's the one that I'm showing you today. It's a luau themed one. Now, I did it kind of last minute and I didn't get to do everything that I wanted to do, but what I did, it worked. And the kids took pictures and it was fun. Even though I didn't get to do all the extra fun stuff that I had wanted to, it still, you know, it still worked out. So yeah, so this is how I created it. I just did all these strips and then basically what you do, it should cut all the way through, and if it doesn't, just tear it. But as you can see, you'll be left with all of these really long strips. And then when you open it up, it'll look something like this. Something like this. And as you can see, this is super long. I won't be able to show you in camera because it's so big. but this part will allow you to wrap it around your background drop. And I used I did the PVC background drop. It was super simple. I followed a tutorial on YouTube. I went to Home Depot and bought all the pieces and did all the cuts, and it was so easy. And I'll show you all of this in this video so you can see what I'm talking about. But you see how I left this little bit of space up here so that I could wrap it around the pipe. I basically just taped mine to the back and it wrapped around the pole, and then you have this part that dangles on the backdrop. So super easy, a lot of fun. I wanna show you the mat. Let me just move this out of the way. It is a self-healing mat, so you can see the mat is just, it's perfect. There's, you know, you can't even tell that I cut it, and I was, you know, pressing down pretty hard using this, and it worked fine, and it's a great mat. I love that it has the ruler on it. That is very helpful. And I was actually able to make a zipper pouch using this mat as well. It's perfect when you have to cut fabric or a little square fabric. You just use your guide, your ruler guide, and if you have to do 10 by 10, you can place it on the squares, and it's just easy to do. So anyway, I highly recommend this product. I will be making more projects. Remember, when you're finished using this, always close it. You don't want anyone to get cut. So just remember to close your blade when you're finished using it, because it could be a serious accident that you don't want to happen. So anyway, this is the rotary cutter. I highly recommend it. I'm loving this mat. I've been using it for all types of projects. So I just wanted to come on quickly. Thanks for watching my video, and I will show you clips of my DIY backdrop, and I will catch you guys in my next video. Bye for now.